Kushagra is asking, how can we get rid of our past and future worries and what else?
That distracts our future.
That distracts our
present.
And
disilluminates our path.
And disilluminates our path. Path goes to where? So you want to get rid of the future so that your path that leads to the future remains good. What are you asking, beta? Look into your question. You are saying, I don't want to think of the future so that my path to the future... Are you not already thinking of the future? It's like saying that I don't want to think of the future so that I may have a brilliant future. I don't want to think of the future so that I may have a brilliant future. Look at the deceptions of the mind. Come what may, the mind cannot stay in the present. Even when it says, even when it recognizes that the past is a load, the future is a load, yet the recognition is very superficial, very theoretical. You know what it means to stay in the present? You won't even be thinking about the past or the future. Not thinking about being a slave of past or future, and not thinking about being free from the past and future. Even to think of freedom from future is to yet be thinking of the future. If I say, what was your name? Sorry?
Kushagra.
If I say, I want to be free from Kushagra, who is still in my mind? So am I free from Kushagra? The more I say, I want to be free from Kushagra, the more I am thinking of? The more I say, I don't want to think of the future, I don't want to think of the future, the more I am thinking of the? Is there anybody here who would claim that he has been listening attentively even for 2 minutes? Even for 2 minutes, I have listened attentively. Yes. If you don't raise your hand, I stop speaking. Very nice. Were you thinking of the future when you were listening to me? Were you thinking of the future when you were listening to me? Were you thinking of freedom from the future when you were listening to me? This is real freedom, where you don't even think of freedom. Real freedom is when you don't even think of freedom. The free man is already free. What does he have to do by thinking of freedom? It's a slave who has thoughts of freedom. The free man has no thoughts of freedom. It's a strange thing. The free man has no thoughts of freedom. He's already free. He's already free. Kushagra, past and future do not exist except in the mind. There is no question of gaining freedom from them. Were they real, one could have fought them and gained freedom. How do you fight something which is already in the mind and only in the mind? How do you fight it? You cannot fight it. You can only understand that it is imaginary. It's gone. Finished. What is not there, how do you fight it? How do you fight a shadow? How can you fight a shadow? How can you fight a dream? Unreal, imaginary things, how do you fight them? How do you fight a dream? By waking up. How do you fight a dream? By waking up. How do you fight a shadow? By throwing light on it. Or do you fight a shadow by beating it with a stick? Do you fight a shadow by beating it with a stick? Just throw some light on it, it's gone. How do you fight a dream? How do you fight a dream? In your dream, you are fighting a monster. A great monster. When you wake up, do you still continue fighting it? Do you even ask where the monster is gone? Do you ask? Do you feel guilty that the monster scared you? You killed the monster. Now do you feel guilty that the monster's wife will come and take revenge? Do you feel afraid? You realize it is unreal, and the moment of realization is it, finished. When the mind, we said the past and the future exist only in the mind, otherwise they are not there. When the mind is roaming here and there, just realize that it is roaming. And there is no need to fight and illuminate the way and all those things that you said about. There is no need. Just realize that these are unreal things. Oh, it's back to its old ways. Again thinking of what will happen 2 years later, 10 years later. That's what it keeps doing. Alright, it's unreal. The only reality is what is happening right now. And I'm into it, I'm enjoying it, fully immersed in it. That's it. Nothing more. Simple. Why make things complicated? But probably you'll be happier if I tell you that if you do Shirshasan and stand on your head, then past will go away. And if you walk on all fours, crawl like, then the future will go away. Then you'll feel good. Yes. Now I have a method. Whenever future comes to the mind, then start walking like a goat. Whenever past comes to the mind, start walking on your head. Good method. How will that help? Think of a man who is carrying a large sword with him and fighting a shadow. And he's very serious. And he's shouting all kinds of things about bravery and singing songs. Veer tum badhe chalo. Fighting shadows. That's the beauty of intelligence. It does not need to fight. It only needs to realize. It does not need to fight. It only needs to realize. And realization is sufficient. Done. Effortlessly done. No need to fight. Done. I am free. Without moving a step, I am free. Standing where I am free. Right now, I am free. No time consumed, no effort taken, no movement needed. I am free. That's the beauty of intelligence. That's the beauty of realization. Sharp, attentive realization. And it's very joyful, I assure you. At times, you may just laugh out. Nothing serious, not at all. Yes, right?